Hi friends, welcome to Biology Tutor. Today we are going to discuss about abattoir. Today is the second day of veterinary science. If you like this channel, please share and subscribe. Don't forget to click the bell button for notifications. Abattoir, a slaughterhouse, also called abattoir. Abattoir means a slaughterhouse is known as abattoir. It is a facility where animals are killed and processed into meat products for human consumption. Abattoir, the Indian meat export are regulated as per Export Act 1963. The meat export in India is regulated by which act? Export Act of 1963. The government of India has laid down standards for export of meat, which include standards for abattoir processing plant and for meat products. Registration and licensing of abattoirs and meat processing plant is done by which agency? APEDA. APEDA are the full form of APEDA. Agricultural and Processed Food Products Export Development Authority, that is known as APEDA. The Export Inspection Council is IC and FSSAI. Act and Rules. The Prevention of Cruelty to Animals Act of 1960, Section 38. The Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, in bracket slaughterhouse rules. According to the rules, animals cannot be slaughtered except in the recognized and licensed houses. Prohibits slaughtering of animals which is pregnant or has an offspring less than 3 months old, or the animal which is under the age of 3 months or has not been certified by a veterinary doctor that it is in a fit condition to be slaughtered. The slaughtering procedures are detailed in order to prevent any unnecessary cruel act in dispatching the animal. The slaughterhouse building must comply with the certain prerequisites in terms of access to slaughtering areas, washing facilities, etc. Abattoirs in Kerala, slaughterhouse corporation in municipality, gram panchayat and total numbers, functional 12, municipality 13, gram panchayat 34, total of 59, and total grand total of 74. Setting up an abattoir. Things to be considered before planning an abattoir. The maximum daily kill of each class of animal should be determined. Proper disposal and treatment of the edible and inedible byproducts. The actual system of operation. A regular full-time skilled slaughterman to deal with all kinds of livestock. The livestock population, type of livestock, marketing facilities and socio-economic conditions of the local area should be considered. Location. The location of the abattoir where animals are slaughtered and meat is produced should comply with rules of Bureau of Indian Standard. Following should be kept in mind. Away from environmentally polluted areas and industrial activities. Free from floods, pests and where waste, either solid or liquid, are dumped and cannot be removed. Like in general, urban sites should be avoided. Rural and nominated sites are preferred. Size. Depending upon the size, small abattoir, medium abattoir, large abattoirs are there. Small abattoir means up to 30,000 units per year. The area required is 1 to 2 acres. Medium abattoir means 50,000 plus units per year, about 2 to 4 acres. Large abattoir, 1 lakh plus units per year, about 4 to 6 acres of land. One livestock unit is equivalent to one adult bovine, that is equal to 2 pigs, that is also equal to 3 calves, that is also equal to 5 sheep. It means one bovine is equal to 2 pigs is equal to 3 calves is equal to 5 sheep. But 1 unit of sheep means 5, 1 unit of calves means 3, 1 unit of pig means 2, 1 unit of bovine means 1. Abattoir facilities. The facilities required in abattoirs are water, electricity, drainage, lightning, up to pest control system also should be maintained. Water supply. An adequate water supply is essential. Water storage tanks must hold at least 1 day's water requirement. Mains pipeline pressure at least 20 psi. Hot water supply of 82 degrees Celsius should be there. Non-potable water must be carried in separate lines. The recommended water requirements is 454 liters per day per pigs, 272 liters per day per bovine, and 45 liters per day per sheep or goat, plus 25% at a reasonable pressure of 15 psi. As per Food and Agricultural Organization guidelines, large animal like buffalo and cattle requires 1000 liter of water. Small ruminants like sheep and goat require 100 liter, pig 450 liter of water. Electricity. Industrial three-phase electricity supply should be provided. Standby generator must be installed. Next one is a drainage. One drainage inlet should be provided for each 37 meter square of floor space. A slope of 20 mm per meter to drainage inlets. All drains has to be trapped with 4 mm screens to prevent the contamination of the effluent. Each floor drain, including blood drains, shall be equipped with a deep seal trap. It may be of P, U or S shape. The drains for bovine material 20 cm in diameter, and for the smaller species it should be of 15 cm. Lighting and ventilation. Adequate natural light and ventilation should be there. It is generally recommended that the overall intensity should not be less than 540 lux. In inspection points, 220 lux in workrooms, 110 lux in other areas. There should be sufficient and suitable means for ventilation to the outside air too. Other facilities. Floor should be impervious, non-absorbent, non-slippery, and should have suitable gradient for drainages. To make the surface non-slippery, carborundum or aluminium oxide is incorporated. For the ceilings, minimum 5 meter height should be there. Doors, it should be at least 2.5 meter high, 1.5 meter wide, and made up of rust resistant metals. Pest control. Insect and rodent screens should be provided in abattoir equipments. Equipment should be constructed of rust resistant metals. The special requirements for the slaughtering of pigs include gaseous tanning, pig traps, caldings, and dehairing machinery. We are going to discuss about some of the terms. Carcass, the body of any slaughtered animal after bleeding and dressing. It is known as carcass. To disembowel and remove entrails of a carcass, that is known as evisceration. What is slayerage? It means holding pens for livestock at a slaughterhouse prior to slaughtering, that is known as slayerage. Red offal include heart, liver, kidney, spleen, tongue, lungs, and pancreas, that are known as red offals. Green offal include the rumen, reticulum, omasum, abomasum, small intestines, large intestines, column, and gizzards. White offal include the brain, spine, bone marrow, testicles, and teeth. Stunning is any mechanical, electrical, chemical, or other procedure which causes immediate loss of consciousness. Fractious animals. Animals that would not submit to the harness. Readily angered, peevish, irritable, quarrelsome, that are known as fractious animals. Unclean or dirty area. Area designated for slaughter operations from stunning to evisceration. Unclean operations include stunning, bleeding, and defeathering poultry in the case of poultry, dehairing in the case of pigs, and dehiding in the case of cattle and small ruminants. That is known as unclean operation. Clean area, area designated for slaughter operations after evisceration to dispatch. Clean operations, evisceration, carcass splitting, and carcass dressing. Abattoir layout, reception area, layerage, slaughter halls, ancillary accommodation, cold storage. Reception. It is meant for collection and marketing of livestock in a large number. The entry point, all stock must be handled gently and quietly. Roof to protect animals and staff. Offloading dock should be about 1.2 meter high to permit careful offloading. The slope should not be more than 30 degrees. Here the animals are examined by veterinarian before sending to lairage. Doctor examines not more than 12 animals per hour and not more than 96 animals per day. You should remember that particular point for your exam. And fitness certificate in the form specified by the central government should be provided. There should be separate isolation pens with watering and feeding arrangements for animals suspected to be suffering from contagious diseases. Fractious animals in order to segregate them from the remaining animals. Suspected animals are sent to isolation pen just like quarantine measures. Lairage. What is lairage? Area meant to give rest to animals prior to slaughter for 2 to 3 days. Done to restore their normal physiological condition so as to get good quality of meat. 12 to 24 hours before slaughter, an animal must be inspected by veterinarians. Animals must be rested for at least for 24 hours. No feed should be given for at least 12 hours before slaughter. Water given as desired. It should accommodate the large animals to be slaughtered in 2 days and small animals for 1 day slaughter. Separate lairages are to be provided for livestock meant for different method of slaughter like halal, jadka or Jewish slaughter. Pen size. The following pen sizes are recommended for housing of livestock in abattoirs. Cattle lose 2.3 to 2.8 meter square per animal. Tied one 3.25 meter square per animal. For pigs, bacon and small porkers 0.6 meter square per animal. Heavy pigs and calves 0.74 meter square per animal. Sheep and goats 0.56 meter square per animal. Slaughter halls. From lairage, animals are transferred to slaughter hall, which is situated about 10 meters away. Drive raises, standing pen, bleeding area, carcass dressing area, inspection area, carcass washing area are included in slaughter halls. Drive or raises. Animals move from holding pen to standing pen through carved path with single file accommodation and stop gate and guided by a person. Standing pen. Area where animals are made unconscious before killing. Its design depends on type of standing procedures. The three most common methods of standing are mechanical, electrical, and using carbon dioxide gas. After standing, animals are suspended by hind limb and moved down a conveyor line for the slaughter procedures. Sticking or exsanguination. It means throat slitting. They are bled by the insertion of a knife into the thoracic cavity, damaging the carotid artery and jugular vein. That should remember, you should remember for your exams. Damaging the carotid artery and jugular vein. This method allows maximal blood removal from the body. Bleeding area. This area should possess a good gradient for collection of blood. The minimum diameter of the blood drain 150 mm, slope to the discharge point not less than 170 mm per meter. The bleeding trough for large animals at least 1.5 meter wide and for small animals and swine 1.1 to 1.2 meter. Carcass dressing area. Here the removal of hide and skin, head removal, evisceration, splitting, trimming and final wash, etc. are performed. Dressing of carcass should not be done on floor. Viscera inspection table is very important. Inspection area. Meat inspection is mandatory to assure wholesomeness, safety and accurate labeling of the meat supply. Visceral organ and the whole eviscerated carcass are examined for pathological lesions. Then it is decided whether the carcass has to be sent to chilling section or condemned meat room or detention room. Carcass washing area, a separately drained area or an area of sufficient size, slope to floor drain. Here, approved carcasses are washed with a jet of water. Ancillary accommodation, condemned meat room, it is directly connected with inspection area. Sorting and holding of materials unfit for human consumption prior to dispatch. Detained meat room, for the isolation of meat requiring further examination. Quality control laboratory, directly connects with the slaughter hall. Microbiological tests, trichoscopic tests, etc. are conducted here. Cold storage, carcass should be chilled soon after the post-mortem inspection. Chilling temperature for carcass should not exceed 7 degrees Celsius and often below 4 degrees Celsius. The carcass is held in chilling room for 3 days. That is known as aging. Blast freezers minus 25 degrees Celsius or lower. Holding freezers of minus 18 degrees Celsius or lower should be used. Cutting and deboning. As carcass is firmly set in chilling room, deboning is easier and it is cut into pieces. Area temperature should be 10 to 12 degrees Celsius. Area illumination should be 220 lux. Packaging and dispatch adjacent to cutting and deboning room. Meat chunks are packaged and after freezing, they are kept under frozen condition at minus 40 degrees Celsius before dispatch. Accessories sections of an abattoir. Blood collection, hide skin store, and up to a fuel treatment plant. These are the accessories sections of an abattoir. Thank you. If you like this channel, please share and subscribe. Don't forget to click the bell button for notifications.